question, which is under 2014-15. So basically 2014-15 questions are almost similar. So I've picked up the questions which are not similar and I've written here. So let us read the first question. Give reasons for the following, right? What is given here? Phenol is more acidic than ethanol. That's the first question. The second question would be boiling point of ethanol is higher than methoxymethane. So let us write one question first. What is the first thing? Here they've already given which is higher. In earlier question, what was it? They've given me an order and they've asked me to justify from the order and write the reason. But here a bit easier for us. What did they do? They've already given the reason. They've already said one is more acidic than the other. So you have to give the reason, right? Now let us see. What do they give me? In the first answer, phenol is more acidic than ethanol. So that's answer is given. I have to prove that. Now let us see. First of all, when I speak in terms of phenol, so in phenol, how is the structure? Your phenol structure is basically this, correct? Yeah. Now, when I dissolve this or when I speak in terms of your double bond, yes. Phenol, when dissolved in aqueous solution, what happens? It's going to break up into two. One is your phenoxide ion, and your H plus. Right, it's going to release because of the electron difference. This is highly electronegative and it's going to drag the electron density. Right, now this is your phenoxide ion, correct? Done. This phenoxide ion, what is the specialty of this phenoxide ion? This phenoxide ion is highly or it's resonance stabilized. What do I mean by that? If I speak about this phenoxide ion, okay, let me write this H plus here, okay, plus H plus. Now observe carefully. This phenoxide ion, yeah, first the electrons are going to, it's going to shift here. Yes, how does this look? It looks like your oxygen has attained a double bond, and again there is a double pi bond here. Very well known, double and double bonds can't exist together. So this is going to shift at this point. Now how do I get? I get a structure like your phenoxide, yeah, and there's a minus and this. Now in the next resonating structure, this is going to drop here, and this, how do we get? We get a double bond oxygen. This bond has dropped here, and this, because double and double can't stay together, so can't be together, so minus. Now in our next resonating structure, this is going to drop in here and this will shift. Double bond oxygen, this is going to shift here. I'm going to get a bond here. In the last step, this charge is going to go, and immediately this double bond is going to shift here. What do I get? I get a resonance structure back and bond. Fine. Yeah. Now observe what's happening. Phenoxide, first of all, phenol when dissolved in aqueous solution, it's going to release out H plus. With this condition, I can just say that phenols are acidic, but not so much as so acidic than acids, but they are they are acidic in nature because of release of H plus. But your phenoxide, whatever is there, it's undergoing resonance, correct? This is represented by resonance, double-sided arrow, and completely it is showing us resonating structure. Hence phenoxide is highly stabilized. Yes, so what is the main concept of phenoxide or phenol? Phenol, due to formation of phenoxide ion and due to resonance, it is highly stable, correct? Right, more the number of resonating structures, higher is the stability, right? So now what are we observing? Why are we trying to explain so much? What did they say? It's more acidic. First concept, more acidic because it releases H plus, point number one. Second concept, it is acidic because it is showing us resonance after release, means release of H plus, and because of this resonance, it's considered as a more stable form of the phenoxide ion, and the most stable form of phenol is phenoxide ion. So because of these two characters, what actually happened? There is distribution of or delocalization of electrons, correct? So every time what happens, this particular concept starts only after release of this H plus, which proves it is acidic in nature. Yes. Now let us come back to ethanol. So when I come back to ethanol, ethanol is here. This is your ethanol. Are we finding any resonance here? There is no resonance because there is no benzene ring for delocalization of electrons. Hence, no resonance. Hence, less acidic. That's it. This is how you're going to reason your equation. Very important, when order is asked, write the order, right? If you're perfect enough with the reason, you can write the reason. But if reason is asked, you have to clearly show it in this way so that you'll get full marks for the question. So this is your first question. We have done the first question. So let us come back and do the next question now. Yes. So what is the next question? They've given me again an answer. Boiling point of ethanol is higher than methoxymethane. This is what they've given me. So when I'm trying to prove the second answer, they've given me two structures. Ethanol. They said ethanol. So first let us write the structure of ethanol. Correct? Yes. Now? Okay. Done. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yes. And they're higher than methoxymethane. So they said ethanol is higher boiling point than methoxymethane. So oxy is your ether. So two methyl groups, CH3, OCH3, methoxymethane. Now they said already they've given me an answer. It is higher in boiling point. What did I say? Whenever you're speaking in terms of boiling point, speak in terms of ionic interactions or speak in terms of hydrogen bonding. Now see here, oxygen atom here is showing hydrogen bonding or no? CH2, C2H5, oxygen. This is electronegative and hydrogen. It immediately forms a hydrogen bonding with one more ethanol. So no, yes, now it's going to form a hydrogen bonding between one more ethanol, electronegative and electropositive atom. Yes, so because of this hydrogen bonding, so what reason will you write? Because of hydrogen bonding, boiling point increases. Yeah, now methoxymethane, will it show hydrogen bonding? Is there any concept of it? It just has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It just has ethereal oxygen, that's it. There is no hydrogen or there is no oxygen-hydrogen linkage, because if to form hydrogen bonding, it should have an electronegative oxygen atom as well as hydrogen atom. But here, there is no existence of hydrogen, correct? So, we can easily write, no hydrogen bonding observed. So if there's no hydrogen bonding, I can easily break the bond. Hence, please write it in bullets. Hence, low boiling point. That's it. This is how you're going to write. In the first reason, first question, you're explaining in terms of resonance. In the second question, you've explained in terms of hydrogen bonding. This is how you're going to write the answer.